favorite food?
I really like spaghetti squash. This is new for me.
This one? Spaghetti with squash?
No, it's like a squash that you like make and then you like scrape it up and it turns into a noodle. But it's
oh, oh, okay. Okay, they're made of squash.
Yeah, that's great.
That's cool.
Yeah. You can do anything with it. I mean, like, like spaghetti squash, like,
Tommy! Wait.
They're
like
hash browns.
I mean, we're
right
out of
subjects here. Yeah, like, they mixed it up with stuff and then fried them and they were like hash browns, spaghetti, but also squash. Like, ice cream.
Yeah.
Spaghetti
squash.
I love squashes.
You know, do you have comfort food, like, that you eat?
Yes.
Yeah. You know, my favorite comfort food is grilled cheese and tomato soup.
Same.
Yeah?
That's a good one.
It's really good.
Yeah.
I like pickle sandwiches.
Oh, I heard that. Oh. Yeah. Pickles? You can use any pickles?
You can use any pickles. Put them in between a piece of bread.
That's awesome. And then you put other stuff in it?
Yeah. If you want, you can put
submitted by all of you guys as a way to try and, you know, as you can tell, move really quickly. Okay, right now, first question goes to Gerard
from Ella.
I love the Doom Patrol playlist you put on Spotify. Is there any plan to do something similar for Umbrella Academy? Were there particular artists or songs you listened to while writing Hotel Oblivion? Or any you associate with specific characters?
Okay, it's a cool question. I think if I had to sit down, and I think the best way to do this is to kind of force myself to make a playlist for Umbrella Academy. I would make two. I would make a general playlist just for all of Umbrella Academy, and then I'd probably make a Hotel Oblivion one. And, the band that I listened to the most were two bands while working on the first couple of Umbrella Academy, the Pixies and Teenage Fan Club. I listened to a lot when I was finishing Apocalypse Suite, the album Bandwagon S. I listened to that over and over and over and over. And then as you know, I don't know how many of you were at the earlier panel, but the longer I kept writing, I found that I couldn't listen to things with lyrics and...
Oh, yeah.
Just, yeah, it got really hard. I was okay for a couple of years, and then I had to switch to noise artists and sound recording artists. So I think I could make an Umbrella Academy playlist that would, like, maybe, like, as a soundtrack. But then I could make my writing playlist, and that would just be ambient. I can do both. I'll do those.
Cool. This next one is kind of is for you and Becky, actually. Haley.
Let me hear you. Yeah,
Haley. Or Hallie. It's Haley. As we approach 2019. How is the real world matching up to your vision of it in the Killjoy comics?
Well, I mean, it's dumb shit.
Can you go out and buy this? And I'm like,
kind of working. Like, why? Like, I don't call you and tell you if you can't go out, leave your job and just go buy something. But it helps if you go outside. They you know, it's like make it seem more like a normal job.
Yeah, because it's like, you know, I try and have, you know, like really, you know, not super strict hours, but I get up early and try to work until like X, you know, 7 or 8 o'clock, and then we'll have like, you know, take a break for food, and then maybe if I feel like it, maybe I'll like draw a little bit that night, and sometimes it's just like stuff for fun. But I always try and take like a few days off a week. Be like, remember, it's, you know, it's okay. You don't have to, even if you're like late on something. You know, I mean, even though that's hard because it's like, you know, you're late, but also like you can't, like, sometimes you're tempted to like stay up super late, you know, to try and get the work done. But the work is never as good as if you just take, you know, just go to sleep like a normal person. You know, and then wake up early and like start fresh.
Yeah.
The stress isn't good. So I try to like take time.
Yeah, like maintaining that balance of like, Gerard, I know you know, have a family and you have like a studio sort of set up separately.
Yeah, similar set up to what you have.
Yeah.
There's a structure on the property that is studio for anything I'm working on, like for music. And then I also have an office in there that's just for writing. And in terms of how I balance everything, I drop my daughter off at school every morning, and then I come in, and then me and Lindsay will have a cup of coffee together and talk about her day and stuff like that. And then I'll go in the studio, and then I'll work till about 5:30. And then at this point, Lindsay has already gotten bed at school. She's only been home an hour and a half at that point. And then I'm done at 5:30. I come in, and I spend time with my family. And I don't work late. I find I don't get anything good done when you're working late. Even if you're late, like Becky said, I used to be able to pull these all-nighters and stay up until 3 a.m. and work all night to hit a deadline, but I just can't do it.
It's
not healthy. Yeah. It's not healthy to bring up working anymore. Yeah. On the weekend either.
I think a lot of it's like becoming really like aware of how you work best.
Right.
Like, you know, aware of what you're, you know, what you need to stay healthy, just like not just physically, but like emotionally.
Yeah, absolutely.
Sometimes it's like, but you know, if you're excited about something, you know, and how like, you know, how you like to start a new project or a new idea or something, and then it's sort of like, you know, you might make a little time for that on the weekend or something, you know, like
yeah,
or a little extra. Or when.
But I feel like that's not my work.
Yeah, it's not something you have to do.
Yeah, because
it's
like I can draw for work, but then they have also like hobby projects. All the time, like right now it's like November, so we draw their own.
I love that.
And it's like a fun thing to do. It's like, oh, you want to draw something for fun? Oh, no, it's a good. Like, remember that you can draw for fun. That's like, you don't have to be like a work thing.
I bring a notebook with me in the house on the weekends, so I have something to jot ideas down. And I like drawing with my daughter and it, so, and she loves drawing, and I've been showing her some things about it. She really wants to learn how to draw, because she wants to be an animator. And so, I'll sit with her, and we'll both draw, so, and usually I'll be coming up with new Umbrella Academy characters, so I guess you could say it's technically work, but I don't really see it that way, because it's an activity we're doing together, and I'll ask her opinion on things, and stuff like that. So I will like draw and write on the weekends, but I'll only be drawing with her. So that way I'm still spending that time.
Mm-hmm. Beck asked, whether writing or drawing a character, do you prefer working on your own original characters or characters already established by other creators, you know? So like, you know, I mean, I know for me, it's like I'll come up with my own stuff, really cool, but I always wanted to be able to draw Batman or write, when I'm writing that G.I. Joe thing, I keep talking about, because I'm excited about that, you know? So is there anything like that for you guys, Gerard?